This warlock build is killing it, guys. We get to run around being charged with light permanently, get unlimited melees and grenades, all whilst constantly healing you at the same time. So guys, I'm Divide. I've done Titan builds, but now it's time to feel the wrath of the warlocks. Stay tuned for this quick build guide. Now, I never used to like the Warlock's top tree solo subclass, but I've been playing around over the past few days with a few different things and I've really started to enjoy this one. It's certainly fun and different to use other than always using the Nova Bombs and Wells. But anyway, as usual with my videos, I want to try and make this fairly short, so let's just get to the point and set up our build. But before we do, we need to know what this build is all about first. So this is a Warlock solo build and will let you run around with unlimited abilities, which you don't need to use any primary weapons or any weapons for that matter. So here's your too long didn't read description of the build. Kill an ad with your melee ability. You then have unlimited grenades for a short time. You spam solo grenades on adds to kill them and spawn elemental wells. You pick these up, which will make you charge with light twice, in addition to restoring ability energy for all abilities. Then rinse and repeat, except this time you're now charged with light and you'll start to heal after every grenade kill. This works nicely because you get one grenade kill, it then heals you, consuming only one stack of charge of light, but that grenade kill spawns an elemental well, and then picking up that well will give you two stacks of charge of light, so you can't really lose and it's just an infinite loop for as long as you're getting kills. If on the unlikely chance your aim is just terrible and you miss your melee or you don't get any grenade kills, then you can just kill a few adds whilst in the air and you'll get your ability back in a few seconds. You could even just use a weapon with Demolitionist or Traveler's Chosen Exotic, but it's really not needed. And you don't need any high stats on your armor, so you can invest in whatever you prefer, like recovery, resilience or mobility, because we're always going to have our abilities ready regardless. But now moving on to making our build work. So you want to go with the Dawnblade top tree here, and this comes with the Celestial Fire melee ability, which is pretty good. But the main thing here that is really going to help the most is this perk here, where Airborne Final Blows grant melee energy. This is good in case you miss your melee or for some reason don't get your ability back, then this will do the trick in just a few seconds of killing adds in the air, which really isn't that difficult. But moving on, you want to use the solo grenades because these are just so good, and if you spam loads of them on bosses, you're going to deal an insane amount of damage, even more if you have focus and lens. But next up for the helmet, we're going with the Lucent Blade. Now you can use whatever you prefer as it's not really essential to our build, but the one thing you ideally want is the hands-on mod so that when we get melee kills, we'll get bonus super energy. But for the arms, we're using the Sunbracer's exotic. Now this build won't work without the exotic, so if you haven't got this one, I believe it drops from a random exotic ingram or from Xur on Fridays. But what this exotic does is increase the duration of solar grenades, and your solar melee kills grant unlimited solar energy for a brief time. But for the mod, you want to use elemental charge so that we can become charge of light by picking up an elemental well. But we'll get two stacks because we're making our own wells, and we'll get to that in just a moment. But for the chest, again, this is up to you and you can use whatever you want as it's quite a flexible build. But for our legs, we're going with the heal thyself. And this will consume a charge of light stack, but heal us when we get a grenade kill. Just be aware that you have to have solar armor energy to slot this mod, as it's a solar mod, so you can change that if you need to. Finally, for the class item, we're going to go with focus and lens so that we deal more damage to enemies affected by stasis. And if your teammates are using stasis, then you're going to do insane damage with those constant solar grenades. The next up is the Inferno Whip. And this is to unstop the unstoppable, or should I say, stop the unstoppable champions rather, with your melee ability if you're going into those harder activities. But if you're not in an activity with champions, you can just switch out to anything else. Lastly, and the most important one, is the elemental ordnance mod. Now you need this mod slotted so you can become charge of light from the mod we slotted earlier. But as well as this, we are gaining the ability energy by picking up those wells when we get kills with our grenade. And you're going to get loads of these spawn because once our melee has a kill, we're just going to spam grenades. Just remember that you need to get the kills whilst in the air so you can get your melee ability back, and you don't have to use your grenade, you can just shoot enemies. But to make the most of this build, just keep up in the air and get kills with your melee, grenade and super, and you'll just own this build and the area around you. But that is our build there. For your weapons, you could use double specials like a sniper and shotgun, but for me, I'd use a shotgun and the lament for boss DPS and the ability build to kill adds. So yeah, that is my Warlock solo ability build, which I think is pretty insane if you can play it right and get used to how the build works. If you can master that, then you're going to clear adds like it's nothing, but that's all for this build here. Let me know what you think or what your favourite build is, but for now, try this build out. I think you'll like it, or check out my other build videos I have so far. Otherwise, as always, like, comment, sub, share, and I'll see you all in the next build.